Hey, what's up guys? Joey Young here. Today I'm going to be doing an update on the monthly 25 gallon. Plus, a little something different. I'm going to be doing a contest entry for NY City Cichlid. He's hosting a great contest. He just reached 200 subscribers. So I'm going to post this link down below. Give him support. And make sure you guys enter as well. Grand prize is $50 cash. Second prize is some Seachem products, so definitely check it out. So I'm going to be talking about, again, my updates on my fish tank. So obviously I put in two new pairs here, and you guys are probably wondering why. What happened to the fry? The fries did not make it, sadly. So only one is alive, and he's actually in the big tank right now. And he was the biggest out of all of them in terms of growth. He grew the fastest, and that was always the one guy that I kind of pointed out in all the other updates. So it's down to one dude, and he's chilling in the big tank, so hopefully he does okay. I could have kept him in this tank, but I decided, you know, to move him out into the bigger tank to let him grow a little bit faster, and also to give, you know, another pair a chance to breed. Because I've seen these two kind of in the other tank trying to breed, but because there's so many other fish in there, they just end up eating the eggs. So like I said in the other previous updates, I think that these are a pair. I just want to confirm them by putting them in their own separate tank and doing their thing. So the one that's over there next to the intake filter, I believe that's the female. The male appears in the front. So once I do confirm, I know that that one's a female, but I want to confirm this one's a male. If they have wigglers, then I know for sure. And this one, the one thing that's going to be different about my first pair versus these are they're the same species, so it's going to be pretty sweet. These are Valentine discus, so I'm hoping that they do breed and I get some wigglers again, and we'll kind of do another trial run in terms of raising up the fries. So we'll see what happens. So these guys have been in this tank for only a couple days, brand new. So we'll see what happens with that. Usually with a sign, when they're already cleaning up an area, they're probably gonna be laying eggs pretty soon. So hopefully they'll lay tonight, tomorrow, or something like that. And hopefully they'll lay away from that intake and closer to the driftwood, which would be a lot better. So let's go ahead and talk about the plants and changes in this tank. As you can see, it's definitely different from the previous update. I went with a different setup. Like I mentioned before, I've gotten some aerials, a bunch of different species. I see a bunch of rows. A lot of in-between plants here are some bruces I had left over from my 60p rescape. I've kept them in here, kind of growing them out until I can either figure out what to do with them, or just end up selling them. Actually, I'm selling two of the bigger ones in here. If you guys are interested, definitely check out my other stores and links. You can definitely buy those. The plants in the back, I kind of moved them around a bit and pushed them in the farther. So what I wanted to do was keep the stem plants, again, all the way in the back. In the front here, more of a low tier slash more carpeting, so that I guess you can kind of see the fish and kind of see the parents for the wigglers, really. So this is really going to be my breeding tank, to be honest. I'm going to be basically switching out pairs in here, you know, seeing what pairs work, what pairs don't, and trying to get some wigglers. Other than the plant setup here, and the aerial is doing pretty decent. I'm going to kind of get off this real quick and get you guys up in here. They're doing pretty good. I am very surprised and happy that these plants are doing really good, just because, again, usually with plants they do a lot better in lower temp, to be honest. In discus temperatures, a lot of plants tend to not do very well, and it's more trial and error. But it looks like these guys are doing pretty decent and pretty good. I had another row going up in here, but it looks like I kind of melted back, so hopefully they do grow back. These discus pair are looking very red and very nice. So hopefully they'll spawn. I did get some new fish, so let's see if you guys can see here. Oh man, this is gonna be very hard. Very hard to see. There's a little plecko right there. As you can see, he's like right there. I bought 6 of these guys, and these are called Starlight Bristlenose Plecos. They're a little bit rarer. They're basically black and white spots with some white tips. Basically pretty much like a bristlenose, but it's a white and black theme. They look very pretty. You guys definitely should go Google it. Check them out. They didn't have any in my pet store. I actually had to order these guys online, and I ordered them small because they're much cheaper that way, even though they weren't that cheap at these size. Pretty much if you buy them like a normal size, you know, 2-3 inch, you're looking at like probably closer to like 60-70 bucks a fish. I bought these in kind of groups, and so I got 6 of them in here. Hopefully they grow out, you know, or at least some of them grow out to be full size, and I'll keep a couple in here and I'll throw the rest in the big tank. These guys are smaller in size. I think they're going to only grow up to be like 6 inches or so, and it's definitely worth it. If you guys have some in your local pet stores, to definitely check them out. They're a different species, and actually I'm starting to collect like the harder species of plecos and whatnot. So I bet you guys didn't know that I was into plecos as well. I definitely was into plecos way back when, and starting that back up again. And still have the SAE here. He's chilling in here. The nerite snails in there. No, what is this? This is the AR mini. Doing pretty good. Plants are doing pretty good. They're growing in back slowly because, you know, like I said, I had to move them around, and they're starting to grow very nicely. Did have a mini algae, I guess, bloom in here. It wasn't too bad. It was just a mini one, just because I had to remove a bunch of plants, and there's not as many plants, but it's not too bad. It's not too bad at all. So, anyways, guys, thank you for checking out the video. Again, definitely check out the contest. I'm going to be posting that link below. NYC Cichlids, thank you for hosting that contest. And peace, brother. And good luck for everyone.